Yo, what's up guys, it's Suraj from Tech Devoted, and I've been using the Sigma 30mm f1.4 DCDN contemporary lens with my Sony A6300 for a little while now. It's actually been 6 months almost, so I figured it was time I reviewed it. So let's kick this off with the build quality, and I think it's built really well. It's mostly made out of metal and plastic, while the focus ring is made of rubber. And about that focus ring, I am not a particularly big fan of the fly-by-wire system, and since it's rubber, it can get like sweaty, kind of like how a pen grip would get if you use it over an extended period of time. And I don't really like that, but I resort to autofocus majority of the time anyway, so it's not that big of a deal. But bottom line, it's built well, it's gonna last. Now before we go any further with all the technical stuff, Sigma, thank you for including a lens hood in the box. They give you a lens hood with the actual lens itself. This was my first one, so I was excited to use it. And honestly, the camera looks infinitely better with the lens hood on. But anyway, back to the point. This lens is a 30mm focal length, which would be a 45mm full frame equivalent. And I think that focal length is just perfect. I mainly use my camera for YouTube videos, which is tech videos. So that means a lot of product shots. And earlier when I was shooting with Canon on the Nifty 50, one problem I always faced was that the focal length was just a bit too cropped in, and it would be impossible for me to get a shot of my product without maintaining a good 3 or 4 feet distance between the subject and the camera. But with the 30mm, that is not the case. It's a bit more wide, and I personally like this focal length better, and with this camera system, that is the A6300 plus the Sigma 30mm 1.4, I can literally just hold my product that I'm shooting in one hand and the camera in the other and get a really nice handheld shot without a problem at all. If you watch my videos, I'm really big on shooting handheld, so with the Sigma 30mm, I can really do that, and that is also partly because of the autofocus on this, which is pretty damn good. I would say it works about 75% of the time. It's definitely not as good as the Sony lenses, but for a non-native lens, it's totally fine, and for most kinds of vlogging, I mean, where you're not moving too much, it's pretty good. Notice how it tracks my face even as I lean forward or backward without taking much time, so it's pretty good. And the motors inside do make a bit of noise while focusing, but in my books it's pretty minimal and it won't normally be picked up by a microphone. I've done several videos where I've had to use autofocus and mount my shotgun mic on top of the camera, but the mic never really picked up the noise from the motor. Let's talk about the aperture. So this lens has an aperture of f1.4. What that means is, one, extremely good low light performance, two, really creamy bokeh, and you can probably see that from the sample footage that you're seeing on screen now. Alright, as I said, I mainly use this for video, but in the 6 months of owning this lens, I've of course clicked quite a few pictures. In fact, some of my favorite pictures ever have been taken with this lens. I also recently took this to my cousin's wedding, and boy did it perform well. I feel 30mm is also a really good focal length for photography, especially candids, and again, pair that with the f1.4 and you get some absolutely gorgeous results. Now as you can probably tell from the samples, even wide open at f1.4, the lens is incredibly sharp, and as for chromatic aberration, there is a bit of it wide open at 1.4, but I found that stopping it down to like f3.5 to f4 pretty much got rid of it in most places, but of course you could also just remove that in Lightroom. Vignetting is also noticeable wide open 1.4, but stopping it down to like f2.2 pretty much fixed it. So overall, I have been fairly satisfied with my purchase, but a part of me still wants the Sony counterpart, the Sony 35 f1.8, because again, as I said, I mainly do handheld video, and sometimes while shooting with the Sigma, I really wish it had stabilization. Like, that's literally the only thing that's missing from this lens. Autofocus would also obviously be better on the Sony, so if you're strictly looking at a lens for video, the Sigma is incredible, but I still think the Sony would have a slight edge over the Sigma in terms of stabilization and autofocus. And given a choice, I would still prefer it over the Sigma, but while I was out shopping, it was out of stock everywhere, that's the reason I didn't get it. But let's say you do 100% stills, or 70% stills and 30% video, or even 50% stills and 50% video, I think the Sigma would be a better buy because it's probably a lot sharper, at least in theory, and it's also cheaper than the Sony, and the difference is actually quite a considerable one. But at the same time, the Sigma is a bit longer, so traveling with it might not be easy. So I mean, it really depends on what you're looking for. If you're on a budget and are looking for something for pictures, Sigma is the way to go. Or if you are doing mainly video and you don't mind spending a little bit more and you're going to be traveling a lot, Sony is the one to get. So that is it for this review, guys. This is actually my first lens review, if you will. So let me know what I can work on. I definitely want to do these more frequently. But if you found this been helpful, give it a like. If you didn't like it, let me know why you didn't like it. It's been Suraj. Thanks so much for watching. Take it easy and stay devoted.